Their problems are deemed personal. People often think this is just my problem. It's because of me or because of my particular circumstances that I am experiencing this problem. And the key message to convey to people through social movements, through organizing, is that their problems are not personal. Their problems are collective. And only through collective mobilization and participation in politics can they begin to address the problems that are not personal, but collective. So that is one response I would have. The other response is, you said that now there are women running for the highest level of office in Brazil. And there's a recent study conducted in the United States by Nancy Burns, showing that in the United States, as more women run for the highest offices, for United States Senator, for governor of the state, when women are running for these higher offices, the women voters participate more, become more informed. They're much more likely to know the names of the candidates. They're much more likely to know that there is an election. They're much more interested in the election. They become mobilized just by the presence of more women running for the highest offices. And so I would take that as a hopeful sign, as a way of opening up the system to more women participating that may work indirectly.
Gracias, Tali. Ahora, Buffy.
Hello. According to my experience, 2003 in Nigeria Republic, before coming to Nigeria, I worked with Minister of Education in the context of traditional school, Islamic school in Niamey and other parts of Niger, Nigeria Republic. So we found that the most difficulties for the family in the area, how they can take religious studies with a modern education. So we are working on that program, telling them that leave children to learn. For the future, it will be determined. Any kind of education has its own impact on society and the child. We usually say so. So when I came to Nigeria, in Sokoto, I found the same problem in Islamic family. Most of them, they are looking modern education sometimes as an obstacle against their tradition. But now, the system that you are looking in Sub-Saharan Africa in general is to try to put together Western education with traditional education. These are the programs that we are working now. Done from Niger Republic that you call Franco studies. They put together French language and Islamic studies that they are doing right now. They have special program for that and Minister of Education. The same program is coming little by little in Sub-Saharan Africa in general, and this program is coming forward in Abuja that they may like to put Islamic studies or Islamic tradition way that they call Makarata Zaure with Western education, so that the family will be sure that their children are not always learning this Western education, because they were afraid for a long time ago from colonial system. They did not understand that learning, however it is, it will trace something for the future. However it is, they did not understand this time, but now time is coming with the globalization system that anything that you are doing, it will serve the society as how it will serve you. So I think that is the answer of the question that you asked me, that there is no any religion can be against learning. All the religion, whether Christianity or Islam, they supported learning, because it's only learning you can able to make difference between bad and good. You can make difference between animal and human being. You can make difference between big and small. That's all.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead.
I just want to add something over here. That when you're asking about the traditional practices and then the community practices, we always try to kind of, you know, like celebrate. But I am always having a kind of dilemma because for the past 15 years, I'm working with different groups and the communities in India. And there are so many community practices which is highly anti-human and anti-women. For example, in Maharashtra, if the fourth child of the family is a girl, then the name that has been given to that girl is Nakosha, means not wanted. So the whole question is that, okay, the family, which is the immediate kinship place for you, and the family where you can go for your kind of any distress, is telling you that you are not wanted. And then and that is a system. So I have, in my case study, we have minimum 10 nakoshas. People have been named as being not wanted. And then there are in places like Haryana, there are customary practices which is called the Kafe Panchayat, that is the caste panchayat. That means there are different clans, and it is the marriage is not allowed between different clans, and if the different kinships, and if a man and a woman from different kinship marries, and they will be traced and beheaded. And recently, one of the things that happened is that after 15 years, because usually these people flee from their places because they are very afraid of the customary practices, they were traced after 15 years. And that time they're having two kids. They were brought back before the panchayat and said that now you have to live like sister and brother and we will look after the kids. So this is a very strong, and the High Court is given a verdict against this, and then the people are retaliating against this, saying that this is our customary practices. So we see sometimes I'm in a kind of dilemma that we are entering into certain kind of inclusive governance and the customary practices again against women. So this whole question about the exclusions, it's also there in the traditions, in the customary practices. So the moment we are saying about, you know, we should have the community, we also should be very beware. The community can also have its very high equations of inegalitarian systems that is within the community. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. ¿Más preguntas, comentarios? Le preguntas a Manchula, do the stories they write, can they read them after? No. Do they get published, the women's stories?
See, in most places, the women are not completely illiterate to write the stories. So there are workers who are working with the women within their language.
Can you turn on your...
In most cases, the women are not literate to document their kind of histories. So there are women, people who are working with the women and getting that transcripted and writing it, so that subaltern stories are very much available.
Okay. ¿Alguna otra pregunta? Yo tengo el privilegio de estar aquí organizando esta discusión, así que puedo hacer mi propia pregunta ahora. Porque me parece muy interesante, las tres presentaciones hablan de, en cierta forma, de diferentes ángulos, diferentes experiencias históricas, culturales, la complejidad de atacar este tema del género y la participación y de la educación. Y esa complejidad creo que se enlaza con temas de estructura, con temas de cultura, de religión. O sea, es sumamente complejo, no es solamente crear espacios pensar en las reglas. Y me hubiera gustado que hubiera más gente aquí, porque este tipo de discusión me parece es muy importante llevarla a cabo a través de todo este congreso, ¿no? O sea, no parcializar la reunión, la discusión género en una sesión, sino discutirla transversalmente a través de todas las sesiones. Un tema que surge aquí es el tema de la politización de la vida privada. En última instancia, transformar temas que no son sujetos o que no eran sujetos al debate público y a la regulación incluso estatal, y tomarlos como temas públicos, sacarlos al aire, ¿no? O sea, es el tema que Manjula planteó, y me parece que esto es muy importante. El segundo tema que se planteó también en la presentación del colega de Nigeria es el tema de la necesidad de democratizar a la sociedad civil misma. O sea, que un poco se tocó ayer al final de la última conferencia, que a veces idealizamos un poco a la sociedad civil como la salvadora de, la impulsora de la democracia, de la igualdad, pero también es un espacio en donde ese tipo de desigualdades profundas, o sea, el tema de las castas en la India es un tema muy, muy importante que no lo podemos ignorar. O sea, no hay una sociedad civil, hay muchas sociedades civiles y muchas están en conflicto. O sea, y esto hay que, en cierta forma, asumirlo cuando vemos el tema género, el tema participación. Y estos serán unos comentarios solamente para responder a alguna de las temáticas. Yo quería preguntar en términos metodológicos, la presentación de Tali me pareció sumamente interesante. El tema este de que los hombres también cuando están solos les va mejor para participar. O sea, porque siempre los espacios han sido crear espacios para las mujeres que puedan juntarse solas para hablar. Esto me parece sumamente novedoso e interesante. Me gustaría saber cómo midieron, o sea, pues en parte la participación en tu presentación, me imagino que no en el trabajo escrito está más explicitado, se hablaba de participación y se medía por el tiempo en el tiempo en que la gente hablaba, o eso es lo que yo entendí, en las reuniones. Y me imagino si uno no puede afinar un poco más del instrumento para ver no solamente la cantidad, sino la calidad o el impacto de, o sea, porque es posible hablar menos y tener mayor impacto. O sea, no sé entonces, en términos metodológicos, si estamos solamente midiendo el tiempo que la gente habla o el impacto que tiene en el tipo de decisión que se adopta, ya sea consensualmente o por mayoría simple, ¿no? Ahí vas a question for you. Yeah. Sí, pregunta si puede responder. Yo le dije que sí porque tenemos todavía unos minutos más.
Thank you very much for those comments. Just very quickly, because I know we're almost out of time, that I appreciate the question about what is the actual consequence of that speaking behavior that I documented. And in further results that we've just produced, we found that the ratings of influence are deeply influenced in turn by the speaking behavior. In other words, when we show that men are dominating the speaking opportunities, when they're dominating the floor, they're also getting higher ratings of influence from the other participants. And conversely, when women are taking up more speaking time, their ratings of influence really go up dramatically. And so in terms of the perceptions of influence of the participants, of each other, these speaking patterns are very, very important. So that's a quick answer to your question. And then the next step in our project